Good evening. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Heavenly Father, we have gathered this evening in your holy name, and we ask for your clemency as we beseech you. And we ask you to send down the power of your Holy Spirit. May your presence abide and remain and fill this room, ceiling to floor and corner to corner. For we need you strongly in our lives, for we cannot do without you. As this invocation is going on, Father, we ask you for all these boys and girls, 2022, we ask you, as we are about to send them out to the external world, Father, there are a lot of ugly things out there. As I pray for them, I ask you to fill them up with the power of the Holy Spirit so they can be protected anywhere they are. Father, defend them from the attacks of evil boys and girls out there in colleges. And we ask you to cover all of them with the blood of Jesus Christ. For without the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, there is no salvation for us all. We ask you, Father, as we invite you in our midst, to be with us to the end of this ceremony, and we give you all that glory, all that honor, all that adoration. So may the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. God bless you.
Hello and welcome, faculty and staff, Father Charles, family and friends, to the graduation ceremony for the 14th class of 2022. I would like to give a big thank you to Mr. Langhouse, Mr. Hain, Mr. Leach, and everyone who made this event possible and supported us along the way. When I was young, I feared my future and life after school. It was hard to imagine a life beyond this place. I thought, I'll be here so long that I won't know what to do when the time comes to leave. But with education and help from teachers, friends, and family, I know that we will all face life head on. It has been a long time coming, but we finally made it. After years of hard work and dedication, the moment has come for us to walk our own paths. Like it or not, we have made so many memories in these halls. Today may mark the end of those memories, but it is also the beginning of our lives in the world. We will always have memories, but our time has come to create experiences that will provide more memories, hopefully even better than those that we have shared together here for so long. So I urge all of you to go forth and forge your own paths. Enjoy the times we've had, but don't linger on the past. Make the most of the present, and look to make the brightest future you can for yourself. We've spent a lot of years looking forward to and waiting for this day. So enjoy this ceremony, and take a moment just to appreciate what you've accomplished to get here. Although today is the last day we sit inside these halls as students, we will leave with a new independence and the opportunity to live our lives to the fullest. At this time, please enjoy the senior meeting.
Thank you. Minnesota. And it's snow outside the first half. I just wanted my name to stop. Now look at where we are, still growing. Still growing. I'm gonna lay in my bed and dream about what I've become. Can I go to get old? Can I go to do something? Now that I'm here, wish I was still young.
Tell me why. On behalf of my fellow classmates and myself, I would like to begin by thanking everyone that has helped us get to where we are today. Mr. Langhouse, Mr. Hain, the school board, faculty and staff, Father Charles, Deacon Larry, parents, family members, friends, and fellow classmates. As we, the graduating class of 2022, sit here today, we realize that our high school careers have come to an end. We have been preparing and waiting for this moment for the last 4 years, and now I am proud to say that we made it. Even though we may not want to admit it, we will all miss high school. We have made so many memories here that it will be hard not to look back one day and want it all back. We will miss more than just the sports and school dances. We will miss the constant support from our classmates and teachers that we have known since kindergarten. 13 years spent in school have made it feel like our second home, and the people in it have become our second family. With this realization, our class has chosen the song, I'll Always Remember You by Miley Cyrus. I believe that this song reflects the feelings my fellow classmates and myself will feel once we all part our separate ways. As the song says, after all these years, there'd be laughter and there'd be tears. As such a small class, these lyrics seem to be particularly fitting for us. We all know each other on a personal level, which is rare for a graduating class. Growing up, we have learned not only from the school, but from each other. This is only one of the many reasons why it is so hard to go our own ways and say goodbye. The song also says, never thought I'd walk away with so much joy, with so much pain. This is a great line to relate to the bittersweet ending of our high school years. It may be sad to walk away, but it brings me joy to think about our future successes in the lives that await us outside of Fort Jennings. As I wrap up tonight, I want to leave you with the words of Miley Cyrus. I'm so thankful for the moments and so glad I got to know you.
Yes, it is God, and we have you, baby. fourth Jennings class of 2022 is all good things come to an end. This quote really puts into perspective that the last 13 years we have spent together is finally coming to a close, but it does not make letting go any easier. The friendships, memories, and lessons we have made in this building is something we will hold with us forever. Now, if I ask any of your parents here tonight, what are the good parts you remember about school? Most of them are not going to talk about sitting in class, the tests they took, or all the homework they did, but they're going to talk about the fun stories, their friends, or the amazing things they got to do. When my classmates and I begin to look back over our years here, we will think about an elementary school when we had to put hands on our hips and bows on our lips, how we used to take the silverware from the cafeteria out to recess and getting straws taken away from the whole school. Or in every gym class, someone would always hit a light with a ball and have to run a lap around this gym. As we moved into junior high, we remember when we went swimming at Cole's house and woke up the next morning with a chemical burn because there was too much chlorine in the pool. But at least we had fun. There was also that time in gym when we were playing hockey and Ellie and I were going for the puck, but instead missed and broke my thumb. But I think the last 4 years is something we will all remember the most. The walks we used to take with Mrs. Harmon outside, trying so hard to stop us from our whole class by talking about the most random things, or us girls going on walks around the school and somehow missing the day always ran into us. We would think about John singing Taylor Swift on the bus during our class trip, getting to see Ryan dancing around all the time, and going to get Mr. Hay McDonald's before school every Friday. Moments like these, along with all the other amazing memories we made, are what we are going to remember forever. So, to the class of 2022, congratulations on everything you have accomplished to be here tonight. Now it is true, all good things must come to an end, but I hope as you walk out those doors tonight, you remember all the amazing things that happened here. However, after today, we will be making new good things within our lives, and I can't wait to see where it takes us. Good luck to everyone, and thank you.
Family, friends, teachers, and all of the administration, I want to thank you for the unconditional support you have provided us throughout these 13 years. It is because of your guidance that we get a stand up here as a class of 2022. Tonight, we will become Fort Jennings High School graduates. Together, we recognize our triumphs, our victories, our achievements, both individually and as a class, and celebrate the journey we have embarked towards our future. In a few moments, we will together turn over our tassels and walk out those doors, no longer as students, but as alumni of Fort Jennings. Everyone has prepared us for this day to come. It started to feel real the day we got to pass the gas. Trying everyone in Mrs. Vaughn's room, realizing in a few short weeks we'd be wearing them all together for the last time. It hit us that our time together was quickly coming to an end. It is now time for us to go out into the world using all the lessons we were taught here to guide our futures. As we go out into the world, meeting new people and making new memories, we will never forget the ones who led us up to this world. Our families, who provided the love and support necessary to succeed. The teachers who motivated us to do our best even when we felt like giving up. And most importantly, one another who could always count on our support. We have all anxiously waited for this moment to come, for us to say goodbye to Fort Jennings and each other. As this ceremony comes to a close, we, the class of 2022, will stand before you together for the last time. Excited for the future the world holds for us, and knowing we are prepared by it because of the unforgettable lessons that have been instilled in us. Though it is sad we are ending this huge chapter of our lives, I am proud of everything we have accomplished together and look forward to seeing what the future holds for the Fort Jennings class.
Good evening. I have the great privilege and distinct honor to present the Fort Jennings Community Scholarship, the Fort Jennings Community Scholarship is awarded to a deserving male and female graduate. The criteria for the scholarship includes outstanding leadership abilities, community action, scholastic ability, and involvement in extracurricular activities. I wish the entire class of 2022 best of luck in their future endeavors, and always remember to be better. Our female recipient has displayed community action by volunteering at our local church and community festivals, as well as tutoring our elementary students. She has been a member of the National Honor Society and has been a class officer. Our female recipient has also participated in soccer and cheerleading and plans on furthering her education in the University of Cincinnati, majoring in pre-physician's assistant program. Our 2022 female recipient of the Fort Jennings Community Scholarship is Ellie Lindman. Our male recipient of the 2022 Community Scholarship has been active in the National Honor Society, Scholastic Bowl, Envirothon, basketball, and class officer. His community involvement includes volunteering at church festivals, soup kitchens, and helping our local preschool. He will be attending Rose State College and majoring in nursing. And our 2022 male recipient of the Fort Jennings Community Scholarship is Nicholas Wurst. Good evening. Thank you to the class of 2022, Father Charles, Board of Education, teachers, staff, Managed Career Center, and family of the graduates for being here tonight. It is my honor to be able to be a part of this ceremony to wish this senior class the best of luck in the future. Class of 2022, as I wish you the best of luck in the future, I want to leave you with two things. Number one, keep it simple, because life can get very complex at times, especially in this crazy world right now. And let's not forget, you all had several very, very interesting years of high school, too, dealing with everything that was going on. And number two is a quote that I came across this year, and goes along with our theme in the high school. The quote is by Lorenzo Snow, and it is, "Be better today than you were yesterday, and be better tomorrow than you are today." What does this quote mean? Well, to me it means every morning when you wake up, decide right away what and how are you going to be better today. For example, if you have a habit of running late, do better and be on time. If you spend too much time on your phone, be better the next time and cut back a few minutes. Be a better friend, brother, sister, son, or daughter. If you've been meaning to reach out to someone special and have been putting it off, stop what you're doing and give them a call. Spend a few extra minutes studying. Help a coworker. Complain a little less and count your blessings. When things go right, celebrate them. If things go wrong, know that tomorrow you can and will do better. These little things are simple things in life. They do not have to be huge acts or life-changing decisions. But if you do it every day, the little things and the simple things will add up to big things. So class of 2022, keep it simple and keep getting better each and every day. With that said, I would like to honor our graduates, and I will start with two well-deserving students out of the 2022 graduating class that have worked very hard throughout their career at Jennings Local. First, the salutatorian, Nicholas Wurst. Nick, please stand up. Nick is the son of Ryan and Melissa Wurst. Nick is a member of the National Honor Society and participated in varsity basketball and track. He has always remained very active throughout his high school career,
and during that time he has earned a 3.91 GPA. Nick will be attending Rhodes State College majoring in nursing. Our salutatorian, Nicholas Worst. Now for our valedictorian, Haven Knippen. Haven is the daughter of Andy and Janelle Knippen. Haven serves as the president of student council. She is a member of the National Honor Society, serving as vice president, and she is a member of the Scholastic Bowl team. Outside of school, Haven is the vice president of the Fort Jennings Showman 4-H Club and is a Putnam County Junior Fair Board member. Throughout her many activities and busy schedule, she has earned and maintained a 4.0 GPA. Haven will be attending the University of Finley, majoring in pre-veterinarian. The 2022 valedictorian, Haven Knippen. Now, to highlight a little bit about all these 28 graduates, 13 students will be entering the workforce. 14 students have plans of going on for either their associate's or bachelor's degree, and one entering the military. At this time, many of these students have already signed their employment contracts, and those students enrolling in college have earned and accepted over $259,000 in scholarships. Please join me in a round of applause for these accomplishments. Seniors, one last time, on behalf of Jennings Local School, the Board of Education, the staff, and myself, I would like to thank you and wish you good luck in the future. And remember, be better today than you were yesterday, and be better tomorrow than you are today. And at this time, then, could I please have School Board President Cliff Weeding to come forward to present diplomas. The following students have successfully completed the requirements for graduation set forth by the Ohio Department of Education and the Jennings Local Board of Education. Keaton T. Seaver. Gavin Michael Gilbert. Chase T. Seaver. Andrew D. Bowers. Gabrielle Elise Martz. Joseph Roger Clear. William Joseph Lucas. Abigail Rose Tester. Ryan Scott Ettinger. Mackenzie Sue Burgat. Noah M. Core. Evan Michael Joseph.
Roadhouse. Casey A. Siever. Aaron T. Bush. Jesse Brian Catlin. Gage E. Stone. Ellie Elaine Lindemann. Troy Matthew Kaplan. Nicholas Andrew Wurst. Jonathan Robert Grody. Braden Joseph Bolinball. Haven Neve Knippen. Gavin Kenneth Schindler. Aubrey Marie Jacobin. Nicholas James Trentman. Kaylee Danielle Gilchrist. Cole Gomer Steele. At this time, to conclude our presentation of diplomas, could I please have Ellie Lindemann come forward to perform her last official business as class president.
In our last act as seniors of Fort Jennings High School, we will be moving our tassel from one side of the cap to the other, symbolizing our movement from candidate to graduate. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my pleasure to present to you the Fort Jennings High School Class of 2022.
Congratulations, boys and girls, for this awesome and wonderful accomplishment. And we hand it over to God as we pray for you. The book of Psalm 91, verse 11 says that he will give his angel charge of you. What does that mean? That the angel of God will guide you, direct you in all your ways. And we pray for you so you don't stumble anywhere you are. And anywhere you are, I ask you, I tell you, remember where you come from. You are from Fort Jesus. We are proud of you. So we send you to the whole world to explore the world and again to bring good news to us in Fort Jesus. and make us proud. Anywhere you go and wherever you go, always remember your parents. Your parents will not have afflictions or vicissitudes of life because of you. And anywhere you are, know that St. Joseph's parents before Jennings and all of us have you in mind and we are praying for you. So let us tell you, some of you know the prayer, the angelic prayer, as we say. St. Michael the Archangel, send us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. God rebuke him in humble prayer, and do thou praise of heavenly host by the divine power of God. Cast thee to heaven, Satan, all the evil spirits who roam throughout the world, see the wind of souls. And with this prayer said, Father, give them protection from enemies, demons, devils. I hand all of them over to you, Father. Watch over them and guide them in all you do. So may the Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you.